part of the tower in London was construction and Roman foundations, and the White Tower was built by orders of William the Conqueror. The Tower of London today is a storehouse of history and tradition. For instance, no doubt you've noticed the ravens. Well, there's an old saying that if the ravens ever leave the Tower of London, the crown will fall. Now, let us proceed to the White Tower. White Tower. This was built by the Bishop of Rochester in the year 1078. They say this tower was a prison of Sir Walter Raleigh, and in it there's a very fine collection of armor.
Ah! My necklace, the ruby, it's gone!
Charlie Chan?
Oh, please come in, Your Highness.
Thank you. Have we met?
Regret never having had honor of personal meeting. However, I've seen many of your photographs, particularly in today's newspapers.
Well, if you've seen today's papers, you can guess why we're here.
Oh, please permit me to introduce number one son, His Royal Highness Maharaja of Rajput, Your Highness the Maharani. Please sit down.
Thank you. I read all about you in the magazines. I understand you're a baseball fan. So am I. What do you think of the Dodgers?
Young man, I was a native New Yorker before I married the Maharaja, but I haven't seen a ball game for 3 years, even though my father is one of the main stockholders in the Brooklyn Dodgers.
I'm sure the Maharaja and Maharani have something else to talk about, Barry. Loss of necklace, no doubt, hmm?
Oh, it isn't just a necklace. It's worth a fortune.
That ruby has more value than money. It belongs to the history of India. It dates back 2,000 years. I'm offering a reward, $25,000, to anyone who can find the necklace. Are you interested, Mr. Chan?
Money not important, but case most interesting. Happy to offer humble service.
And there is something else, Mr. Chan. We are planning a trip to Paris this week, and we need a private detective to guard us against any further thefts. You were recommended to us by Scotland Yard.
Compliment of Scotland Yard, most flattering.
Well, we had a private detective before. We hired one in New York a year ago. My husband just fired him.
And why not? Three thefts in 1 year. And today this so-called private detective allows us to lose the Rajput ruby.
Well, I don't see how Joe... Well, if all those guards in the Tower of London let a necklace get stolen, how can you blame Joe Rotella?
I have no tolerance for inefficiency. Well, Mr. Chan, may I count on your help?
Every endeavor by humble self will be made to recover Ruby.
What puzzles me most is why anyone should try to steal anything, even from a tourist, inside the Tower of London. This is one of the most closely guarded places in the world.
So's Fort Knox, but then they...
How anyone could get it out of here is beyond me. We shut all the gates. We held all the tourists for 9 hours. Everyone was searched.
The tradition of the Tower inspector is very well known, and efficiency of the guards can never be questioned.
Speaking of guards, didn't the Maharaja and his wife bring their own bodyguard along too?
A private detective called Joseph Rotella. He's from New York. Do you know him?
Mr. Rotella has recently registered at the same hotel as Son and I. However, we have not as yet met.
Mr. Rotella must be as embarrassed as we people at the Tower. He was standing next to the Maharani when she missed her necklace.
Did you search him?
We even put him in front of the X-ray machine.
What about insurance?
The Maharaja and his wife carry no insurance.
No insurance? She wears a jewel around her neck worth a fortune and she doesn't carry insurance?
The Maharaja is so wealthy, it's unnecessary for him to carry insurance. He has a personal fortune estimated at 500 million pounds.
Inspector, we are most grateful for your kindness and patience.
The Tower Guard, aided by Scotland Yard, has been working on the theory that the necklace was never taken out of the Tower. A thief may have concealed it someplace.
And come back for it later when the smoke blew away.
That theory has been thoroughly explored and exploded. I have a report here following a 24-hour search inside these walls. The Rajput ruby is not in the Tower of London.
So how has it gotten out of here, Pop?
Very logical question. But for best answer, must ask thief who stole same. First sign of age when man cannot tie shoe from standing position. Oh, excuse me.
We no speaky Chinese, but thanks.
Know who he is, Pop?
From speech, would say man of very bad manners.
Lefty Ryan. Came up from the Texas League. I saw him win two games off the Brooklyn Dodgers with terrific southpaw pitching. Batting average, 240. Why, they even cheered him in Brooklyn.
Evidently, Mr. Lefty Ryan very popular in Brooklyn.
Not for long. Not with his temper. I saw him get thumped out of the ballpark for trying to hit an umpire with a baseball bat.
Amazingly bad taste for any ballpark.
Why, he got thumped out of baseball completely. Last time I heard of him, he couldn't even pitch his way back to Texas. So what's he doing in London?
Most likely on Goodwill Tour. Strange door is unlocked.
Come in, Mr. Chan. It's your room. My name's Joe Rotella. I'm taking a plane for New York tonight, and I just wanted to see you for a minute before I left.
Most likely place to find me, of course, is my own room.
How did you get in, anyway?
Passkeys. I thought every private eye had them. Can I give you mine, Mr. Chan?
Must refuse most gracious offer.
Maybe your son might like them. Compliments. Rotella Detective Agency.
Thanks.
In case you're wondering why I'm here, Mr. Chan, it's just a friendly call.
Oh, have made friendly calls myself many times. But I'm now embarrassed to realize I committed social error by ringing bell or knocking on door instead of using passkey.
Look, Chan, I only want to let you know what you're getting into. You know, in the past year that I've been working for the Maharaja and his wife, there's been three big jewelry losses, and that's not including the Rajput ruby. And I don't blame myself.
Who do you blame?
The Maharaja. You know, he's got more money than he knows what to do with. He carries diamonds and rubies around like they were peanuts. And then he met Ida Kelly.
Ida Kelly?
Maiden name of the present Maharani. She was just a pretty kid from Brooklyn until she married the Maharaja. And, well, sudden money went to her head. She didn't know how to use it.
But if her father's one of the chief stockholders of the Brooklyn Dodgers, why...
No fooling. Has she been feeding you that line about her old man?
Well, then he is not stockholder at ballpark.
He may own a part interest in the jar of mustard, I don't know. It's a sense she doesn't own any part of the hot dog stand. He just works there. Well, you can have my job, Chan. I've had enough.
Most grateful for a kind warning.
I've been knocking at your door, sir. When may I take your bags?
Oh, later. They're not packed yet.
I understand you're moving to another hotel, sir. Nearer to Hyde Park.
You've got your parks mixed up, kid. I'm taking tonight's plane to Central Park, New York. I'll let you know about the bags.
Thank you, sir.
Well, good luck, Chan. You're gonna need it.
Very sensitive young man.
He's staying right here in London. Why did he tell us he was going to New York?
A very simple reason comes to mind.
What's that?
Mr. Rotella lost both job and reputation when Ruby was stolen. If he can now recover same, will regain reputation. Also, added inducement of big reward.
Maybe he has a different reason. Maybe he's hanging around London because of the Maharaja's wife. The score adds up.
Score?
The clue. Right here in this room, you heard the Maharaja's wife try to defend Rotella. Why would she defend a man her husband just fired? Answer, she's having a secret romance with Rotella.
Secret romance like dead ant in pepper pot, very often difficult to detect. I shall be downstairs in bar.
Mr. Charlie Chan, he's in the cocktail lounge.
Mr. Charlie Chan speaking.
Well, Pop, I was half wrong, but I was half right, too.
Since birth of number one son have mostly discovered first half, would welcome discovery of second half.
I was right about the romance, but wrong about the man. It's not Joe Rotella, but it's Lefty Ryan. I even got the picture to prove it.
Sometimes being half right makes up for being half wrong. Soon as politeness permits me to leave my guest, join me in our rooms. We will then see Mr. Rotella.
Right, Pop.
Get me a cab, will you? Yeah, and send somebody up to get my baggage. I'm in a hurry.
Going someplace?
How'd you get here?
We're going into business.
Business?
Let's call it partnership. 50-50 on the Rajput ruby.
I don't know what you're talking
Look,
about.
Look, all I want is a split. If I don't get it, I might get rough.
Still don't know what you're talking about.
Keep quiet or you'll get hurt.
Mr. Rotella.
Your cab's waiting, sir.
Better call doctor.
Wait a minute. I'm okay. Here, what's going on here anyway?
You asking us?
How'd you get in here?
Keys, your keys.
You do not wish doctor?
Doctor? What for? Because I had one drink too many and fell on my face. I was celebrating my last job, Chan. Believe me, losing that job is something to celebrate. First thing I knew, the floor came up and smacked me right in the button.
From appearance of room, one may conclude Mr. Rotella engaged floor in very bitter struggle.
I wonder what the floor finally hit him with, a right or a left.
Here, now look, what kind of a hotel is this? Can a guy have any privacy? Guys have to keep barging into his room?
Please excuse intrusion. However, understand your feelings perfectly since someone recently barged into my room also. Remember?
Thanks. That was a bluff, Pop. He's not drunk. He just had a fight.
Congratulations on astonishing ability to perceive the obvious. It's also very obvious Bird is about to fly from this. Suggest you follow him, perceive where he alights.
Okay, but what about you?
I will now have conference with Maharaja. Enter, please. But where, how did you get these? On many occasions, ethics prevent private detectives from divulging secrets.
I shall divulge a secret to you, Mr. Chan, in strict confidence.
Secret, when told to another, is no longer secret.
Nevertheless, it concerns my wife. Before we were married, she was engaged to that man.
Mr. Lefty Ryan?
Yes. Before our marriage, Her Highness told me about it, and it was understood that she would never see him again. Last year, however, in New York, I overheard her by telephone arranging to meet him.
Old romance like cat sometimes has nine lives.
He followed us to Paris. He stayed at the same hotel. And yesterday I saw him again. He was in our tour party in the Tower of London.
Your concern is most understandable, Your Highness.
You appear to have succeeded where Retailer failed.
I do not understand.
Well, I employed Retailer to follow this man and my wife with a candid camera. That was a year ago.
Prescription, very good. But medicine had no effect. He brought no pictures, hmm?
No. And he failed to prevent the theft of valuable jewels. I was right, the man is completely inefficient.
Apologies, but I have come to a different conclusion. Please, may I speak with your wife?
Her Highness is in her rooms, but I shall inform her that you wish to see her.
Would prefer to see her there, alone. Your Highness.
Come in, Mr. Chan. My husband told me you were coming. I hope you won't be too long. I'm expecting my hairdresser.
My most humble apologies for being obliged to disturb me. However, a crime has been committed in the theft of the Rajput ruby.
Who took it?
You did, Your Highness.
I did? Are you trying to tell me I stole my own necklace?
Not exactly, but you did smuggle it out of the Tower of London. You had hoped the guards would not search the victim yourself. And if they did, you could merely say it slipped down your neck without your knowledge.
I don't get this. My husband owns half of India. If I needed cash, would I steal my own necklace?
You were forced to obtain money without your husband's knowledge for blackmail.
Ah, ridiculous.
Your Highness, I have just seen examples of Mr. Rattella's photography. Two candid camera shots of yourself and ex-player of baseball.
Ah, what ball player?
Very colorful name, Lefty Ryan. As number one son would say, Lefty was one southpaw pitcher. But Mr. Rattella also knew Lefty as southpaw sweetheart to Your Highness. However, Mr. Rattella did not show pictures to your esteemed husband. Instead, Rattella made you pay for his silence. Waste paper basket, very poor place to throw pitcher for which you paid so much. The Rajput ruby.
Ah, you're talking in riddles. If I wanted to present Joe Rattello with a ruby necklace, I'd give it to him at any hour of the day or night, in any place. Why should I go through all that hocus-pocus in the Tower of London?
Because Joe Rattello thought that if the jewel were lost or stolen in such a highly guarded place as the London Tower, then the Maharaja would never blame him for the loss. Please, may I use telephone?
Be my guest.
Thank you. Operator, Mr. Chan, I am expecting a call from my son. I shall be in suite 914. Thank you. Thank you.
Dicker?
Yeah?
I have a letter from a friend of yours.
Now, please don't forget to make that call.
The Rajput ruby?
Pretty, ain't it?
But dangerous. Too dangerous for anyone to buy.
That's why I'm here.
I'm looking for a gift. A friend of mine said I can find some nice rings here.
The shop is closed.
Well, I just thought I'd look around a little bit.
Not,
you know.
Today. The shop is closed.
Perhaps I can... All right, shut that door.
But who are you?
Shut it. All right, now inside. You had it after all. All I have to do is turn it over to the police and collect the reward. Good thing
Shut
I
up.
Thought you... Or maybe you've changed your mind. Maybe you'd like to play ball, huh?
Sure. You're the boss.
That's fine. Hey, what's going on here? I thought you...
Mr. Rotella and I are partners. There's no harm in telling you that now. When it's dark, you're going to be wrapped in a parcel and dropped in the Thames River.
Yes, Mr. Chan speaking. Oh. Yes. Thank you. Shall take care of same immediately. Yes.
Please, Mr. Chan, I need your help. There's nothing serious between me and Lefty Ryan.
Please excuse me. Very mysterious call from taxi driver. My son in very serious trouble.
The shop is closed, sir.
No doubt for repairs, hmm?
You must leave now, sir. Must close shop.
Someone lost keys.
My own keys, sir. I dropped them.
Seem very familiar. Seem like keys once presented to a very close relative. In fact, I remember these keys as well as my own son. Over there, please.
Sure was scared for a while, Pop. Scared that the taxi driver might keep the tip and forget to phone you where I was. Oh, police will catch up with him. Name's Jan Dicker. Expert stonecutter. He was about to cut up the Rajput ruby. Right there. Where Teller brought it.
So, ex-playoff baseball has been playing on same team as Mr. Rotella, huh?
Yeah, he followed him here, hoping to blackmail the blackmailer.
Very important now. Telephone Inspector Duff.
Okay, Pop. Operator, give me Scotland Yard. Inspector Duff, please.
Now please to return pass keys which fell from your pocket in another room. Very fortunate coincidence.
Coincidence? You think these fell out of my pocket by accident? Pop, can't you give a guy credit for anything?
Most humble apologies, my son. Very difficult for aging father to realize number one son now growing up.